How do I recover encrypted files from Cryptomator? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's jump right to the question. As files are encrypted by Cryptomator, how can I identify a file to recover a previous version? I can't even see where I'd find version history. The very, very short answer here is that you cannot, and I will show you exactly why here in a moment. What you need to do is prepare, and we'll talk about that as well. So, Cryptomator on disk. To be clear, when you have a Cryptomator vault mounted, you tend to access it through some other drive letter. For example, here I have secured in Cryptomator, and you know there are files that I would access directly, normally, like any other file. But these files are not stored on disk in their unencrypted form. They're in their unencrypted form here, but that's because Cryptomator is providing us an unencrypted view on the files. If we actually take a look at what's literally stored on the hard disk, in this case, I'm going to go over to my OneDrive, and you can see here I have a folder dedicated to Cryptomator that I just happen to call Secured in Cryptomator. If we go inside that folder, we can see stuff, but it's not particularly helpful stuff. And I say that because everything that we care about, the files that we've stored in Cryptomator, are encrypted. It's all in this D folder, and then you get some random folder names and another random folder name, and then a bunch of files that all have random names. You get the idea. There is nothing here that would allow us to associate one of those files with the unencrypted version of the file we might be trying to access. So there are two ways to do this. If you need to recover a specific file from Cryptomator, one, mount Cryptomator, use Cryptomator. I mean, if there's nothing broken, then you should be able to simply mount this folder in Cryptomator and basically access its entire contents without hesitation. Now, it's important to know, and it's useful to know, that it doesn't have to be on the machine you set it up on. One of the nice things about Cryptomator, it's a side effect of the job that it's trying to do, is that if you need to, you can copy that entire folder tree somewhere else. So in this case, for me, that would mean taking this secured in Cryptomator folder and maybe dragging and dropping it to an external hard drive. Or if I were trying to recover maybe a crashed machine that had this somewhere on its hard drive, I could somehow access the hard drive some other way and drag and drop this folder and everything in it to an external hard drive, another hard drive, whatever works for you. Once the copy is complete, you can simply set up Cryptomator and mount it again with the same passphrase you used originally. That is, I think, something that people sometimes overlook. And when you think about it, it's kind of a side effect of how it's designed. Cryptomator was designed to make encryption of individual files useful on cloud storage sites like OneDrive, like I'm using it here, or Dropbox, or Google Drive, or any of a number of other things. By definition, that implies that these files may show up in different locations on different machines if they're all accessing the same shared cloud service. So even if you're not using a cloud service, if you're using Cryptomator for something else, just copy the tree somewhere else to a working system, presumably, and you should be able to access its contents normally. Now, the other approach that I refer to as being prepared will not surprise you in the least because I've talked about it before, and that is back it up. And specifically, back it all up in its unencrypted form. So while I do, for example, back up my OneDrive and that will have these encrypted, weird-looking files, I would also then look at the unencrypted version, the mounted version, and make sure to back up these files in their unencrypted form. Now, that does imply, yeah, they're encrypted for a reason. There's probably secure information in there. So that does mean you need to take care to encrypt or otherwise secure the backup. But I would do that in a different way. That could be something as simple as a password-protected zip file, which is what I use, and storing it in a different location, which is what I do, that is itself secure. It means that if you ever need to use them, yes, there's going to be a couple of hoops you need to jump over. You need to recover the zip file, remember the password to the zip file, unzip what you're looking for, and so forth. But it's a backup. You've got the files one way or another. So the bottom line here is that, yes, you can be prepared from almost any problem you're having by having a full and proper backup. You can back up the contents of OneDrive, but I recommend you also back up the unencrypted contents of whatever you've secured in Cryptomator. Now, there are a couple of, I just call them grasping at straws. There's still other approaches that may work for you. They may not. For example, I just mentioned that I back up my entire OneDrive that includes these encrypted files. Well, in theory, if you then restore that entire backup of OneDrive, that would include the encrypted files that you could then, in theory, mount again in Cryptomator. You can copy the entire tree of encrypted files somewhere else, like I talked about before. That way, you can mount it. You can rely on an online backup. In this case, OneDrive is where I've got my encrypted files. That implies that it's at OneDrive.com online. If, for some reason, I lose the first machine, that may be the only machine connected to my OneDrive.com, I can still, on another machine, go to OneDrive.com and download that entire encrypted folder and then be able to, again, mount it using Cryptomator. And like I said, it's sometimes we forget that this whole point of Cryptomator was to make tools like OneDrive that much easier to actually use securely by making it easy to encrypt the files they're on. If you've got another machine that's using the same OneDrive, that's literally connected to the same OneDrive account that you do on whatever machine you might be having a problem with, go over there. You should be able to, again, mount the encrypted files easily if they are all present on that other machine. Now, I have one last little piece of advice. When you create a vault in Cryptomator, you will be given the option to create a recovery key. Do that. There is no way to recover the contents of your vault if you forget your password. Literally, no way, except if you can then provide this recovery key. So create the recovery key, much like the unencrypted backup that I was telling you about earlier. So store that in some secure alternate way so that if you need it, you can get it again. A good place to store the recovery key might be in a password vault. That way you've got the credentials for Cryptomator and the recovery key that you might use to reaccess a vault that you've forgotten the password to. Hopefully this helps you understand what it is you might need to be able to do to not only back up the contents of your Cryptomator vault, but what it really means to access a single file and why that isn't really that easy at all. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/169864. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.